very open about that. She's recently retired, and this is something on her bucket list she wanted to try. This is her opening 5 minutes. I know you'll be very generous, and she is wonderful. Ladies and gentlemen, Patricia Field. Woo!
It's great. I can't see anything.
Yeah!
Okay. Who here does laundry?
What?
Everybody.
Laundry? I love laundry. There is something about the fact that washing machines eat socks. It is a known fact that everybody has this bag of socks with no partners. It's horrible. So my family comes to visit me, and I think I'm going to be nice, and I'm going to wash their laundry so they can go home with clean clothes. And lo and behold, I find 3 individual different socks for my brother. And I'm like, crap, it did it again. It ate the socks again. So I just decided, you know what? I'm going to go to the store. But before I go to the store, I'm going to curse out this washing machine because I have the most up-to-date, modern washing machine dryer, all the bells and whistles, everything fabulous, and still the socks keep missing. So I decided I'm going to go to the store, I'm going to buy socks, I'm not even going to tell my brother there was a problem, I'm just going to give him the socks and say, have a nice trip home. And then it hits me. He's an amputee. Oh. He only has one leg. And I thought, how can somebody forget something? I can't. Every year, women go to the gynecologist. We hate it, but we go every year because we want to stay healthy. So we're grabbed and squeezed and fondled and pushed and put in positions that are so embarrassing and also make you feel so vulnerable. Basically, we're assaulted once a year. Basically, that's what it is. Any other stranger who did anything remotely like that would be catching some charges. No doubt. And the insurance companies are in on it because they pay the doctors to do these things to us. So, this is years ago, I'm in the gynecologist's office, he does his magic, and I'm sitting there, and he says to me, he goes, you have cystic breasts. I said, okay, is there anything I can do about this? He says, yes, you have to stop drinking so much caffeine in your coffee. And I said, well, how much coffee is too much? This is what this man said to me. He says, your breasts will tell you. He doesn't know me. But you can't say something like that to me and think that I'm not going to come back with something. He just doesn't know me. So I look at him and I go, well, my breasts haven't said anything to me the past 40 years. What makes you think they're going to start talking to me now? Do you know that he didn't crack a smile? He didn't laugh. He just sat there. And I'm like, man, this guy does not get out often. I've got to get out of here. I mean, this is more uncomfortable than the actual visit itself. I got to go. My husband and I, we love going to Chinese restaurants. The best part is really the fortune cookie. So my husband and I go to this restaurant. We are fighting the entire time. We fought in the house, we fought in the car, we fought at the restaurant. And now it's the end of the meal, and we get the check and the cookies. So I grab a cookie. He takes the cookie on the table, and he reads it. You will find new love. And I said, you know what? If you keep up acting like this, I will help you find that. Then I open up my cookie. And it says, KMS, the golden rule. And I'm like, these Chinese cookie people are learning a little bit about Christianity? The golden rule, love your neighbor as yourself? KMS, the golden rule, keep your mouth shut. Of all the people who could have gotten that cookie, I had to get that cookie. My husband let me live that down. He has that little piece of paper in his top drawer in his desk. And he just, every once in a while, takes it out, and we have an argument, and he goes, KMS? KMS? Okay. Who here has grandkids? Anybody have grandkids? Grandkids, if you don't have them, they are the best thing that could ever, ever happen to you. They're just so wonderful. So I have a 5-year-old granddaughter named London, and she is a riot of a human being. Let's see if I can. This is the kind of girl that London is. She's 5 years old, she's in kindergarten, she's fighting with this little girl. The teacher gets them both together and they go, she goes, you're friends, you have to say you're sorry, you have to apologize. So the little girl apologizes to London. London will have none of it. She's just standing there. So the teacher goes down like this. She goes eye to eye with London. And she goes, London, we're friends. You have to apologize, and we're going to get on with our day, but you will apologize. London looks her in the face, and she goes, where did you get those crazy eyebrows? That's London. So London comes to my house, and she's going to have a bath. So we go in the bathroom, and she takes off her little clothes, and then she realizes there were some toys I want in the toy box in the dining room. So if you have to picture this. My husband is here, and my son is here in the dining room, and London comes dancing out naked, and she goes into the toy box, and she starts rifling through the toy box like this. And this is what she says. Don't worry, guys. I'm not naked. I'm just getting toys. And I was like, oh, my gosh, this magical thinking. What happens to that when we become adults? What happens to that? Do you know how useful this could be in your life? I'm not cheating. I'm borrowing the answers from somebody who actually studied for this test. I'm not cheating. I am not having an affair with your husband. I am just trying to get you, I'm helping you get rid of that pain in the neck that you've been trying to get rid of all these years. I'm helping you. I'm not robbing a bank. I'm just doing some creative finance. Remember to be kind. Aww. Thank you.